Hey everyone, welcome. It was last year at the Sea Otter Bike Festival here north of Toronto, where I had the chance to try some entry-level e-bikes from Norco. And to my surprise, none of those e-bikes were running the e-bike specific drivetrains. Shimano has the LINKGLIDE, SRAM has the EX1. They were all running the Deore drivetrains, whether they were 12 speed, but more often than not, they were the M5100 11 speed, and some of them were running the 4100, the 10 speed from Shimano. I have the shifting bits from 4100 with me today. Let's check them out. Both the 10 and 11 speed options offer a 2x version of the drivetrain, but today I'm gonna focus specifically on the 1x components. To figure out what component works with what drivetrain, Shimano has this table online that should clarify things quite nicely. And if that looks quite complicated, yes it is, and that's probably one of the reasons why Shimano just introduced their Shimano CUES. That's supposed to actually replace this 4100, 5100 for that mid and low price point bikes in the near future. So for now, let's focus on this. And if you stick around, I'm gonna have something special for you folks at the end of this video. So what I have is the cassette shifter and derailleur, and I'm gonna put them side by side with M5100. And first of all, just like the 5100, this cassette can use the good old Shimano HG freehub. So if you have older bikes like this one with 135QR, you can very easily upgrade this to either 1x10 or 1x11. But if the 5100 uses this aluminum carrier with the largest cogs bolted onto it, and then a whole bunch of loose cogs. And by the way, I have a video, I'm gonna link it up in the corner with all the details of this cassette. This 4100 cassette is all steel. What you see here on the back looks like an aluminum carrier, but if I take a magnet to it, this is all made out of steel. And on a close look, you see this big cluster at the end, and then all the other loose cogs, all of them being riveted together. Three big rivets right here, clearly visible. 5100 uses the same plastic tube that the 12-speed drivetrains use. This makes it very easy to install. And as you pull this out, here goes all the loose cogs. This 10-speed 4100 uses this little plastic cap. So you just pull that out, and here we go. The only loose cogs that you see here are the 11 and 13 steel lock ring. You're gonna have 40 newton meters here and the product number made in Indonesia. Both the 11 and 12 speed provide you with an 11 to 42 tooth that I don't think anybody uses. But if you're looking at this 1151 versus 1146, the big difference here, it's gonna be at the end of the cassette where you see a big jump here from 37 tooth to 46. The 11 to 51 has 39, 45, 51, which is pretty much what their 12 speed cassettes use. So this 46 tooth feels more like a bailout gear, but Shimano is well known for doing this. Look at their M8000, for instance. Most of the time you buy these cassettes for durability, made all out of steel. And here's the weight, 623 grams. Here's the 10 speed 1146, 522 grams, so 100 grams lighter. Shimano has always used that riveted design on their more entry level cassettes. This one is no different. They usually last forever and they were built like a tank, all steel construction. Weight might not really matter, especially if you're using this on an e-bike or a very entry level hardtail. So overall, great bang for your buck on this 4100 cassette, but I would argue that the 5100, the 1151, it's a lot more popular because of the wider range. What about their little shifter? How is this any different from the 5100 shifter?
I have the 4100 on the left, I have the 5100 on the right. How can you tell? Well, you can't really tell because these two shifters are absolutely identical. Interestingly, both of these are manufactured in Japan and they provide you with three maximum gear shifts. That would be downshifts, upshifts are one at a time, and you can shift these, the two-way release, so either by pushing or by pulling on that lever. Shimano has them available with a bar clamp or with an iSpec EV adapter like this one. Also, the 4100 exists with a gear indicator in case that's something that you're interested in. Weight of the 10-speed shifter is 138 grams, and that is pretty much the same with the 135 provided by the 5100. So same technology, same weight, same shifters, different number of clicks.
And right next to their front shifters, they're gonna also list this, the MT500. This is the seat pose remote from Shimano. I have reviewed it a couple of times. I'm gonna link it up in the corner. This is a very nicely integrated, cheap dropper remote I would highly recommend. But where things get interesting is if we're looking at their new derailleurs, they offer two, the 4120 and the 5120. This 5120 that integrates a clutch being the one recommended for the 1146 cassette.
And this is where I said that I don't think there's a lot of innovation in this group set, just borrowed design from the past. What I have here is the 5120 Deore, and on the right, this is an XT M8000, so that's previous generation 11-speed. The design is absolutely the same. You have the B link here, you have the clutch, and you look at the shape and the offset of the cage, it's absolutely the same. The only difference from this being a GS or medium cage, the 5120, this seems to be a long cage, so SGS type of derailleur. Other than that, there's no difference, and you can install these on standard mount derailleur. Remove that V-link and you can also install it on a direct mount derailleur hanger, something that the new 12-speed and 5100 derailleurs cannot do because, again, they don't have that V-link anymore. I have this all documented in a video. I'm gonna link it up in the corner. Their even cheaper 4120 does not have a clutch anymore, so I don't think it's even worth mentioning. And by the way, this 5120 derailleur weight is 334 grams and maximum capacity for it is the 46 tooth.
This cassette, just like the 11-speed, is not HG Plus compatible, and that means that you can use it with any chain you like. Shimano recommends this HG 54, I think it is, but you can use any 10-speed chain that you like to use, whether that's KMC, YBN, SRAM, you name it, they're all gonna work fine with this cassette. What about their cranksets? For one-by drivetrains, they list the same M5100 crankset that I have reviewed on my channel not too long ago. I'm gonna link it up in the corner for all the details. And that leaves us with their brakes, and I think the 4120 brakes that they offer, the four piston brakes in this lineup, are probably the most popular. Not only that they work okay, but they are a good fit for something like an e-bike, just like the ones that I tried at the Sea Otter. This drivetrain, maybe with the exception of their brakes, can only be found on new bikes, and especially in 2023, chances are you're gonna see a lot of this. Definitely not the Shimano CUES that they just introduced. And by the way, shout out to bikecomponents.ca. They provided me these parts to review them, and they also provided me with a discount code for you folks watching my channel. Make sure you check it out in the description below. So, have you guys ever used the M4100? Have you used this on an entry-level bike, or have you used it on an e-bike? Let us know in the comments below. Hope you found this useful, and if you did, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. And until next time, hope to see you folks on the trails. Cheers, guys. Cheers.